The Diplomatic Platypus by Patrick Barrington. I had a duckbill platypus when I was up at Trinity, with whom I soon discovered a remarkable affinity. He used to live in lodgings with myself and Arthur Purvis, and we all went up together for the diplomatic service. I had a certain confidence I own in his ability. He mastered all the subjects with a remarkable facility, and Purvis, though more dubious, agreed that he was clever, but no one else imagined he had any chance whatever. I failed to pass the interview. The board, with wry grimaces, took exception to my boots and then objected to my braces, and Purvis, too, was failed by an intolerant examiner who said he had his doubts as to his sock suspender's stamina. Our summary rejection, though we took it with urbanity, was naturally wounding in some measure to our vanity. The bitterness of failure was considerably modified, however, by the ease with which our platypus had qualified. The wisdom of the choice, it soon appeared, was undeniable. There never was a diplomat more thoroughly reliable. The creature never acted with undue precipitation, oh, but gave to every question his mature consideration, oh. He never made rash statements his enemies might hold him to. He never stated anything, for no one ever told him to. And soon he was appointed, so correct was his behavior, our minister without portfolio to Transmoravia. My friend was loved and honored from the Andes to Estonia. He soon achieved a pact between Peru and Patagonia. He never vexed the Russians or offended the Romanians. He pacified the Letts and yet appeased the Lithuanians. Won approval from his masters down in Downing Street, Soholio. He was soon to be rewarded with the grant of a portfolio when, on the anniversary of Greek emancipation, alas, he laid an egg in the Bulgarian legation. This untoward occurrence caused unheard-of repercussions, giving rise to epidemics of sword clanking in the Prussians. The Poles began to threaten, and the Finns began to flap at him, directing all the blame for this unfortunate mishap at him, while the Swedes withdrew entirely from the Anglo-Saxon dailies the right of photographing the Aurora Borealis, and all efforts at rapprochement in the meantime proving barren, the Japanese in self-defense annexed the Isle of Arran. My platypus, once thought to be more cautious and more tentative than any other living diplomatic representative, was now a sort of warning to all diplomatic students of the risks attached to negligence, the perils of imprudence. Beset and persecuted by the forces of reaction, oh, he reaped the consequences of his ill-considered action, oh, and branded in the honors list as Platypus, Dame Vera, retired a lonely figure to lay eggs in Bordighera.